Myself Diksha Ratnesh, Assistant Professor, School of Journalism and Mass Communication, IMS, Noida. And today I'll be delivering a lecture on Online Journalism subject of MJMC 3rd semester. The objective of this lecture is define online journalism, what is the basic concept, a brief history of online journalism, different characteristics of online journalism, and what are the basic advantages and disadvantages of this field. So, online journalism basically refers to the content created and distributed online. In other way, this is a type of journalism which operates via internet. Online journalism should not be confused with citizen journalism. Online journalism is publishing of information that is equivalent to that of its print and broadcast counterpart, such as newspaper, magazines, radio, and television. It follows the professional code of conduct similarly to the traditional journalism. This is how it differs from citizen journalism, which is not bound by any ethical and professional code of conduct. The online medium also provides journalists with a vast range of options to gather information in an interesting and entertaining way. The internet provides opportunity for instant publishing, archiving, linking, use of audio and video with greater interactivity, and also provides instant shares feedback. The journalist activity is primarily conducted for dissemination of information. It also simplifies the process of information flow to a large audience. Online medium is not only posing a challenge to the conventional media, but is also forcing them to adopt changes in their newsroom operations and news delivery platforms. With a few clicks, you can now access almost the entire world of journalism and its vast variety of sources along with multimedia materials. Holi defines online journalism as original writing and reporting that are delivered via the World Wide Web. Today, as we are witnessing that all type of work is getting transferred onto the online mode, the media industry has also not lagged behind but has ventured deeper into it and exploring new opportunities of online news delivery and related online news business. You must have experienced that while trying to search for any reading material, picture or video on internet, as you write certain keywords in search engine, you get result running into several hundreds of web pages. Sometimes these linkages get you onto a blog, many times onto a news website, and occasionally to government websites. All these links do not belong to online journalism. Only websites belonging to the media houses or blog created by professional journalists can be considered as online journalism. Actually, in recent times, you might have noticed that the link between professional and personal journalistic writing are blurring significantly, mainly due to the proliferation of social media and its popularity. But online medium provides all these information and all these facilities. That is why it is the new era of journalism. Now, as we know that internet is the basic of online journalism. So, internet term was first used in the request of comments document published on the TCP protocol. United States Department of Defense Advanced Research Project Agency, DARPA, established in 1969. And when we talk about online journalism, the first type of online journalism called teletext was invented in UK in 1970. Teletext is a system allowing viewers to choose which stories they wish to read and see it immediately. After the invention of teletext, the invention of video text took place, on which Prestel was the world's first system, launching commercially in 1979, with various British newspapers such as Financial Times lining up to deliver newspapers stories online through it. WWW was invented by English scientist Tim Berners-Lee in 1989. And next come to the computer, that was the transmission of online journalism. By WWW, we can see the vast expansion of online journalism. Next came computer bulletin board system in the late 1980s and early 1990s. Online news websites began to proliferate in 1990s. An early adopter was the News and Observer, North Carolina, which offered online news as Nando. Nowadays, we can see lots of online mediums from where we can get news of various fields. We can see the competition there. We can see the variations in the news. Here, I have given some examples of online journalism platform. AddisonCNN.com, these are the websites of different news houses. We can see there are massive users of internet all around the world. That is why there is a broad scope of online journalism in the future. Let's talk about some characteristics of online journalism. You have learned the key features of online journalism. Now let's see that what are the basic characteristics of online journalism. First feature is online. As the word suggests, it operates on an online platform which can be seen or updated in real time. Here's breaking news and events can be updated as it happens, like live telecast in the television, news channels, live updates in the news websites are quite common nowadays. While we have had this facility in radio and TV, also where we gather around and take updated information, the difference here is that it can be seen on your computing devices and even the mobile phones with some additional features. And you can get recent updates also. Second characteristics is shifted time. Online journalism also takes advantages of shifted time. Online publications can archive stories for now or later. Users can read those stories at any point of time of their choices. In other medium, this facility is not available easily in the conventional print media or electronic media. If you want to read any previous day or month newspaper, you have to get access to the news organization library. Another characteristic is multimedia. Online journalism can include multimedia elements like text, graphics, sound, music, motion elements, animation, etc. Different type of digital elements can also be added. Different websites are now implementing different types of features with flash animation, photo gallery, video and audio clips. Another characteristic is interactivity. Online journalism is interactive. Hyperlinks are primarily mechanism for this interactivity on the web. Through hyperlinks, different types of media options are added to a news package to bring more in-depth analysis. Through hyperlinking, various elements of lengthy and complex works are added together in the story. Work of an online journalist consists of hyperlinking of own web pages or at time links to the other websites. Another characteristic is immediacy. As per Encyclopedia of Journalism, news is like bread. It's best served fresh as it goes stale quickly. This statement points to be the fact that immediacy is a key component of journalism. A journalist have responsibility to provide information as quickly as they can. And what better way to do it than through the internet? It is the fastest medium, and through this information can be disseminated from personal computer to mobile. With the ability to upload content anytime through a basic internet connection, online journalism is an immediate as we can get. Another characteristic is hypertextuality. Hypertext is a prime tool used to introduce interactivity in the web pages. Hypertext is a web link which can be used to provide variety of information in one pages. These links carry a variety of media content, video, graphics, animation in a story. Through hypertext, journalists enrich their content. So this being a distinctive, unique characteristics of online journalism. And it helps differentiate online media differently from other forms of media. Another characteristic is global reach. Global reach is a basic feature of online media. Audience is massive here and global in nature. What are the different qualities of online media professionals? There are three levels of multitasking is required of an online media professional. First is media multi-skilling. It means the journalist should be capable of producing content for the different media. Another one is issue multi-skilling. They need to report on news related to different thematic areas. It means a journalist covering crime should also feel comfortable covering politics too. Technical multi-skilling. They are responsible for performing most of the production tasks. For example, reporters may need to do editing work and if needed, work as multimedia professional also. So let's look into the advantages of online journalism. As we all know that it has many key features. So according to that, first is global reach. Global reach is a basic advantage of online journalism. You can reach out to the mass audience for your content. Another is easy publication. On online platforms, it is easy to publish your content. Interactivity. Obviously, when you are on the online platform, you can interact and you can search towards the different types of websites available. Multimedia possibility. You can use text, audio, video, and different types of animations, photo gallery to creating your content attractive. Another one is permanency. What you post on your online platform, online website, it is there forever. If you want to look for those content, you can easily go to the archive and select for those information. Timelessness. You can get the information within no time and you can be updated. Unlimited space. Like any other traditional medium, there is not a single crunch of space on online journalism. You can use as much space you want to use for your content. And another advantage is real time and shifted time feature. Means you can get the information in real time and you can archive those information, you can bookmark those information for your future reference. There are some disadvantages also of this new field of journalism. First is mushroom, or you can say different types of small, big news websites where journalists are posting news and they can also post their opinion. Another one is lack of credibility. It is not easy to distinguish between good and bad news sites as there are lots of websites. So it is difficult for a user to differentiate between good and bad news sites. Another disadvantage is ethical questions like privacy, accuracy versus speed, copyright and advertising. You have to log in on some websites. In that case, you may lose your privacy too. And on the name of speed, online platform may provide different types of news which is not accurate, which is not factual. Another disadvantage is it also creates a digital divide. Means the gap between haves and have not. The people who are having digital platforms, digital connection, internet connection, and the audience which are not having it. So the information can be restricted to that digital divide. Another one is information overloaded. In online journalism, you may get lots of information on different websites. So, as a reader, we are getting lots of information from everywhere. So, in that case, there are chances of overloading of the information. And last is lack of accuracy and credibility. On the name of speed, reporters or online platforms may publish the news which is not accurate, and it also loses the credibility. Thank you so much.